Alicia Pisha, Aloysia Pisha, welcome to Aloysia Pisha.
Hi guys, it's me Alicia, and today I'm going to be teaching you how to draw a lovely tie-dye pattern. So what you will need for this arts and crafts is a ruler. It doesn't matter, but definitely don't use a flexible one because it really won't help. A piece of paper, A4 or A5, or really any size you want, but we're going to be turning it into a square. Some coloured pencils. I'm using it in rainbow for my tie-dye, but you can use any colour you want. So first what we're going to do is we're going to get our piece of paper, and if it's not already square, I'm going to show you how to turn it into a square. So I'm just going to fold it and make sure, fold it into a triangle shape, and make sure that the two corners reach each other, like this. And then I'm just going to make sure it's all in line and crease it down. Don't worry if you make a crease, because we kind of need this crease to help us see where the middle is. Now what we're going to do is fold our, we're going to get our ruler, we're going to put it right on the edge of our triangle, and then we're just going to rip the rest of our paper. Hold your ruler down really firmly to try and get the majority off. So now we have a perfect square. Ignore the little rough bits on this side. You can cut it off if you would like. Now we're going to fold it again the other way. Make sure that the corners are together. And just crease it down. Now we have a sense of where the middle is to start our tie-dye. See? So we don't need our ruler anymore, so we can just put this down. And we don't need this strip of paper unless you want to make a mini tie-dye design. So we can just put that down. Now is the part where we make the tie-dye. So now I'm just going to get my red pencil and draw some lines in a small circle around the base of my paper to make the start of the tie-dye. Spin it around as you go along to give it a nice firework effect. Now I'm going to put my red at the back, and I'm going to get my other red. I'm going to do that a bit out more on it. So quite close to the other red, but just a bit more outer. Now, it may not look like a tie-dye right now, but honestly, once I get to the orange and the greens and the purples and the pink, it will look totally like a tie-dye. So this is what it looks like so far. It looks like a bit of a mini firework, which is nice. So now I'm just going to add some orange. You can't have a rainbow tie-dye without the orange. Now I'm just doing light brush strokes out. There you go. Looking more like a rainbow. So, just going to keep on going with every colour that you are using until you're finished. And we're done! So guys, here's the finished view, and if you want, you can get some scissors and just chop off these edges so that it's nice and curved. Ta-da! So...